This day a solemn feast to Dagon held, relieved me from my task of servile toil. Unwillingly their superstition yields this rest, to breathe hen's air, fresh blowing, pure and sweet.
Wake the trumpets, lofty siren, and wake the trumpets. Oh, was my birth foretold, as in a fiery column ascending from off the altar in my parents' sight? Why was my nurture ordered and prescribed as of a person separate to God? If I must die, betrayed and captive thus, the scorn and gaze of foes, O cruel thought, my griefs find no redress, they inward pray like gangrened wounds, immeasurable growth.
of man, nor fury of the fiercest beast could quell. Who tore the lion as the lion tears the kid, ran weaponless on armies clad in iron, useless the tempered steel, or frock of
to complain of but myself, who hands great trust could not in silence keep, but weakly to a woman must reveal it. O glorious strength, O impotence of mind, but without wisdom what does strength avail? Proudly secure, yet liable to fall. God, when he gave it, hung it in my hand to show how slight the gift. But peace, my soul. Strength was my bane, the source of all my woes. Each told a part would ask a life to wail.
Matchless in might, once Israel's glory, now her grief. We come, thy friends well known, to visit thee.
Welcome, my friends. Experience teaches now how counterfeit the coin of friendship is, that's only in the superscription shown. In the warm sunshine of our prosperous days, friends swarm. But in the winter of adversity draw in their hands those swords not to be found.
Which shall we first beware, thy bondage or lost sight?
Oh, loss of sight, of thee I most complain. Worse than beggary, old age or chains, my very soul in real darkness dwells.
my sight, how could I heave my head for shame? Thus for a word or tear divulged to a false woman, God's most secret gift, and then be sung or proverbed for a fool.
The wisest men have erred and been deceived by female arts. Deject not then thyself, who hast of griefs alone. Yet men will ask, why did not Samson rather wed at home? In his own tribe a fairer, or as fair.
Oh, that I had, alas, fond wish too late. That specious monster, Dalila, my snare, myself a cause, who, vanquished by her tears, gave up my fault of silence to
Here comes thy reverend sire, old man, with careful steps and locks as white as dawn.
Alas, another grief at name awakes. Brethren, and men of Dan, say, where is my son, Samson, from Israel's boast? Inform my age.
As signal now, in low dejected state, as in the height of power, see where he lies.
His fame at last, his life
Als der Sohn Teufel, mostly these evils have befallen thy son. Sole author I, sole cause, who have profaned the mysteries of God, by me betrayed to faithless parties, feminine assaults, to the false fair I yielded all my heart. So far a feminist he held me yoked, her slave. O foul indignity, O blot to honor and to arms, mercy it remains. This day they celebrate with pomps and sports, and sacrifice to Dagon, idol god, who gave thee bound and blind into their hands. Thus is he magnified, the living god blasphemed and scorned by that idolatrous rout. This have I done, this pomp, this honor brought to idol Dagon, but to Israel's shame, and our true God disgrace. My griefs for this forbid mine eye to close, for thoughts of rest. But now the strife shall end. Me overthrown, Dagon presumes to enter list with God. Who thus provoked will not connive, but rouse his fury soon and his great name assert. Dagon shall stoop, ere long be quite despoiled. Those boasted trophies won on me.
Till shame and trouble, all thy foes shall cease.
till shame and trouble, oh, thy foe shall see. Till shame and trouble, oh, thy foe shall see. Does the God of Israel sleep? Arise with dreadful sound. Arise, arise, arise with dreadful sound. And the clouds encompassed round, encompassed round. Then shall the heathen hear thy thunder deep. The tempest of thy wrath arrays, in whirlwinds there pursue and pursue, will fraught with vengeance due. To shame and trouble, to shame and trouble. To shame and trouble, all thy foe shall cease.
Thank you. this loathsome plight.
It should be so, to expiate my crime, if possible.
Shameful garrulity! Had I revealed the secret of a friend, most heinous that, but impiously, to blab God's counsel is a sin without a name.
Be for thy fault contrite, but, O my son, to high disposal leave the forfeit due. God may relent and quit thee all his debt. Reject not then the offered means of life. Already have I treated with some lords to ransom thee. Revenge is sated now. To see thee thus, who cannot harm them more?
Why should I live?
Soon shall these orbs to double darkness sink. My genius spirits droop. My hopes are flat. Of glory run, and race of shame, death invocated oft, shall end my pains, and lay me gently down.
Thank you. from the womb, by him led on to deeds above the nerve of mortal arm. Under his eye, abstemious you grew up, nor did the dancing ruby, sparkling outpoured, allure you from the cool crystalline stream. Where'er the liquid brook or fountain flowed, I drank, nor envied man the cheering grape. But what availed this temperance, not complete, against another object more enticing? I laid my strength in lust's lascivious lap.
Trust yet in God. My father's timely care shall prosecute the means to free thee hence. Meantime, all healing words from these my friends at
decked and gay, comes this way sailing like a stately ship, with all her streamers waving in the wind, an odorous perfume, a harbinger, a damsel train behind. 'Tis Dalilah, thy wife.
My wife, my traitress, let her not come near me.
She stands and eyes thee fixed with head declined, like a fair flower surcharged with dew. She weeps, her words addressed to thee seem tears dissolved, wetting the borders of her silken veil. With doubtful feet and wavering resolution, I come, O Samson, dreading thy displeasure. But conjugal affection led me on, prevailing over fear and timorous doubt. Glad if it would my noble love could serve to expiate my rash and thought misdeed.
Out, thou hyena, 'twas malice brought thee here. These are the arts of women false like thee. Break all vows, repent, deceive, submit, then with instructed skill again transgress. The wisest men have met such bosom snakes, beguiled like me to ages an example.
I would not lessen my offense, yet beg to wait by itself. What is it then but curiosity, a small female fault, greedy of secrets, but to publish them? Why would you trust a woman's frailty then, and to her importunity your strength? A mutual weakness, mutual pardon claims.
Cunningly the sorceress displays her own transgressions to upbraid me mine. I to myself was false, ere thou to me, bitter reproach but true. The pardon then I to my folly give, take thou to thine.
Thank you. 'Twas raging lust, love seeks for love, thy treason sought my hate. In vain you strive to cover shame with shame. Once joined to me, thou judged your country's foe. Parents and all were in the husband lost.
Great the curse, oh, Charms, thy trains, thy wiles, and fair enchanted cup. Their force is null. Where once I have been caught, I shun the snare. These chains, this prison house, I count the house of liberty to thine.
Let me approach at least and touch thy hand.
Not for thy life! This remembrance wake my sudden rage to tear thee limb from limb. At distance I forgive, depart with that. Now triumph in thy falsehood, so farewell.
Thou art more deaf to prayers than winds or seas. Thy anger rages an eternal tempest. Why should I humbly sue for peace thus far?
to love, I'll hear no more. The charmer's voice, your heart give o'er. The charmer's voice, your heart give o'er. Traitress to love, traitress to love, I'll hear no more. The charmer's voice,
that woman's love can truly beat. condole thy chance. I am of Gath, men call me Harbaugh. Thou know'st me now. Of thy prodigious might much have I heard, incredible to me. Nor less displeased that never in the field we met to try each other's deeds of strength. I'd see if thy appearance answers loud report.
No way to know and not to see but taste.
Ah, dost thou then already single me? I thought that labor and thy chains had tamed thee. Had fortune brought me to that field of death, where thou wrought wonders with an ass's jaw, I'd left thy carcass where the ass lay thrown.
Boast not of what thou wouldst have done, but do.
Be honour certain to have won from thee, my lose, prevented by thy eyes put out. To combat with a blind man, I disdain.
Oh. Take for spear your weighty weaver's beam, and come within my reach.
Condemned, a slave enrolled, no worthy match to
to stain the warrior's sword.
Cam'st thou for this, vain boaster? Yet take heed, my heels are fettered, but my hands are free. Thou bulk of spirit void, I once again, blind and in chains, provoke thee to the fight.
O Dagon, can I hear this insolence, to me unused, not rendering instant death?
Dissolve those magic spells.
sacred feast. Thy honor calls, this day admits no rest.
To song and dance we live the day. Song, to dance and song we give the day. With charms I only was day. With charms I only was day. To song and dance we give the day, to dance and song we give the day, which was thy universal sway. Which was thy universal sway, to dance and song we give the day. We chose thy universal sway. We chose thy universal sway. Protect us by thy mighty hand, and sweep this rest from up the land. Protect us by thy mighty hand, and sweep this race, and sweep this race from out the land. Song and dance we live the day. To dance and song, to dance and song we give the day. We chose thy universe. Chose thy universal sway. To song and dance we give the day. To dance and song we give the day. We chose thy universal sway. We chose thy universal sway. Chose thy universal sway. We chose thy universal sway.
Thank you. Consecrated gift of strength, again returning with my hair, by vaunting it in honor to their god, and prostituting holy things to idols.
How thou wilt here come off, surmounts my reach. 'Tis heaven alone can save both us and thee.
Thank you. begin to feel some inward motions which do bid me go.
In time thou hast resolved, again he comes.
Samson, this second summons send our lords. Art thou a captive, slave, and public drudge? Yet dare dispute thy calling when we send. Haste thee at once, or we shall engines find to move thee, though thou wert a solid rock.
Vain were their art, if tried. I yield to go, not through your streets, be like a wild beast trailed.
You thus may win the lords to set you free.
In nothing I'll comply that's scandalous or sinful by our law. Brethren, farewell. Your kind attendance now I pray forbear, lest it offend to see me girt with friends. Expect of me you nothing here impure. Unworthy God, my nation, or myself.
So mayst thou act as serves his glory best.
Let but that spirit which first rushed on me in the camp of Dan inspire me at my need. Then shall I make Jehovah's glory known. Their idol gods shall from his presence fly. Scattered like sheep before the God of hosts.
Oh, at the feast, dost play before the lords, but give you part with me, what hopes I have to work his liberty.
My inheritance but ran.
ransom him, without my patrimony having him. The richest of my tribe.
Sons care to nurse their parents in old age, but you, your his delivery seem not vain, in which all Israel's friends participate.
I know your friendly mind, and
shout!
slain my son.
My son is rather slain them. That cry from slaughter of one foe could not ascend. But see, my friends, one hither speeds, and Hebrew of our tribe.
Where shall I run? Off which way fly the thoughts of this most horrid sight? Oh, countrymen, your end is sad event to much concern.
The accident was loud, we long to know from whence.
Let me recover breath, it will last forth.
Tell us the sum, the circumstance defer.
Gaza yet stands, but all her sons are fallen.
Sad not to us. But now relate by whom?
By Samson done.
The sorrow lessens still, and my converts to joy.
Oh, Manoah, in vain I would refrain. The evil tale too soon will rudely pierce thy aged ears.
Suspense in news is torture, speak them out.
Then take the worst in brief. Samson is dead.
The worst indeed. My hopes to free him hence are blasted all. But death, who sets all free, hath paid his ransom now.
No!
and cleansing herbs, wash off his clotted gore, then solemnly attend him to my tomb with silent obsequies and funeral lamentation now, no cause for grief. Samson, like Samson, fell, both life and death heroic. To his foes ruin is left, to him eternal fame.
Why should we weep or wail, dispraise or blame, where all is well and fair to quiet us? Praise we Jehovah then, who to the end not parted from him, but assisted still, till desolation filled Philistia's land.
concerts of